Hi, I'm Heidi Joy Trathaway with the OpenStack Foundation, and I'm here with Steve Dake from Cisco. We're talking about community health. And Steve, I wondered if you would tell us a little bit about your involvement in the Community Health Initiative.
Sure. So I'm new to the board of directors this year, and as part of that, I volunteered to lead the Community Health Initiative. I have a deep background in community health across probably about 20 years of experience in terms of open source. And to me, community health is one of the most important things that we can have as a community.
Yeah. And I wonder if you will tell us a little bit more about the background of the Community Health Initiative and kind of some of the conversations that have been happening up until now.
Sure. So the board had a strategic charting initiative, and there were five areas that were picked out. I'm only going to talk about the community health area today. All the areas are very important to us, to the board and the TC and the user committee. Although our focus is just on community health, when we did that work, we decided there were two areas we could focus on, onboarding or building leaders. So we decided to vote, we voted, and there were 15 for onboarding and 16 for growing leaders. So we decided to focus on growing leaders because that had a slight edge on the voting. I think if you look at the foundation in general, they're very much supportive of onboarding, and we don't really have to do much there already. That's already being taken care of. That's a problem that's being solved. But the community, growing community leaders is critical, and we're just getting started on that as a community because it's not something we've really identified in the past. It's something that was needed to be done.
Yeah. Well, looking back at the last user survey, I see quite a lot of comments about community. When we ask people what they like best about OpenStack, they consistently rate community either highest or one of the highest things on their list. So it's clearly valuable to the members of the community.
Right.
And so I wondered if you could talk a little bit about how we look at community health. I mean, do we measure it, or what are the attributes of community health that indicates to us that our OpenStack community is thriving?
Right. So I'm a firm believer in that you fix the roof while the sun is shining. And our community rocks. Really fantastic community we have in OpenStack. I think if you look at what we want to do, we want to be able to measure how leaders are evolving in OpenStack, and we haven't done that to date. In terms of doing that, we don't have a clear solution to that problem, how to measure it, but we are taking some very small steps initially to get things kicked off.
So, okay. Hey, don't worry about it. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. So, you're taking some small steps.
Yes, we're taking small steps, yeah. And the small steps are important for us to grow the community over time, or to grow the leadership over time. The first thing we're doing is we set up 3 lightning talks for people to do lightning reviews. We believe that the lightning reviews are a way for people to become core reviewers in OpenStack, and then potentially become TC members in OpenStack, and potentially become board of director members in OpenStack. So, or other parts of the leadership in OpenStack. We think that what we want to do is we want to take those 3 videos, pilot them here, and then expand them into other parts of the different core reviewer teams. So, for example, Nova wants core reviewers. They could participate in these videos where their core reviewers do basically a lightning review of how they do a review. And we think that's critical to growing the core reviewer base. And by there, everybody kind of rises up as a leader. So we're taking a very small incremental step here. I expect more later in terms of what we want to do with measurement. That's something we haven't really discussed, but we're going to get to in the coming months.
So I like how you've charted out this course with kind of those incremental steps that can take a person on a path to greater leadership within the OpenStack Foundation. I wondered if you'd tell us a little bit about what is the vision or kind of the longer term steps that we might see taken to ensure the health of the community.
Yeah, longer term, I think, is more of the same in terms of the onboarding. We need more onboarding. And that's not really a problem we're tackling, but that's something that needs to happen to lead into the core reviewers, right? We need to have people that are developers first, and then they learn how to become core reviewers. In terms of our long-term steps, you know, doing these videos, this might be the first step. We're going to have to maintain these videos. So every year or so, they're going to have to be redone because the core reviewers teams change, the makeup of the TC changes, what people expect out of their leaders change.
Yeah.
So we expect every year or so we'll have to revise these videos. And then we're going to do more. I would like to see more work out of us. One area we're really focused on, or I'm really focused on, I'd like to see the rest of the board interested in as well. We have this thing in OpenStack called the Stewardship Working Group. So the stewardship working group, their responsibility is to steward OpenStack into the future. Now you think of a stewardship of the planet, that's like taking care of the planet, right? This good thing, we want to take care of OpenStack.
Yeah.
The stewardship working group is way ahead of the board actually in maintaining kind of onboarding and also growing community leaders. So we're gonna lean on that working group. We're also gonna learn from them because they're ahead of us in some degrees. What I would like to see though is that they're properly funded inside of OpenStack, which shouldn't be much of a difficulty, and that they're free to do what they need to do and left hands off for the most part. Those are the two real actions we have coming into Summit. Coming out of Summit, I think we have a whole lot more than we need to focus on.
So do you think you'll be digging in, reviewing some of the Etherpads and coming up with maybe some more actions for that committee going forward?
Yeah, it's not really a committee. It's more like a working group. But
a working group?
Yeah, working group, yeah. A committee is a whole other thing.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, so we don't want to get into that territory necessarily. I think we definitely will review what happens in the onboarding sessions. Mm-hmm. Because I haven't been able to attend all of them because there's plenty throughout the summit. Lots of projects have onboarding sessions. But I'd like to see what people had in terms of questions in those onboarding sessions. And I think the rest of the strategic board initiative that's responsible for community health would like to see that as well. So I would expect we will review that. I would also expect we'll have some form of measurement for that. Although it's really hard to measure growth of leadership. Companies do it all the time. You know, they set up systems to measure how well their leadership pipeline is set up. That's a really challenging problem to solve. I don't know how to solve it immediately, but we might take a stab at that. We might not. It depends. What we're doing now, we know won't be harmful. So we just want to change a few variables at a time because we don't want to harm our community in any way. So, although I don't think it could be harmed, it's entirely possible it could be.
Well, all of these plans are really exciting, really encouraging. So, Steve Dake, thank you for joining us.
Sure. It's a pleasure, Heidi. Thank you.